guys, you know what time it is. It's your boy David at the Irish Hotspur, Ireland's number one Spurs fan, bringing you the predicted lineup for today's massive Carabao Cup second leg in the semi-final versus Chelsea. Of course, we are joined by Jack. But look, Jack, let's waste no time. Let's get straight into it. Let's give them the predicted lineup. What formation are we going with, Jacko?
We're going through 3-5-2 here, Dave, and I think the reason we've gone for a 3-5-2 here, the main reason is potentially because, you know, we do have that huge, you know, miss with, you know, Sonny, of course, being out injured. The other reason as well is, you know, we are coming up against a side that it did feel like in that first leg where we needed that extra body in midfield. And also we had a great, you know, performance against Liverpool with the 3-5-2. So those two reasons, you do probably feel like, you know, Antonio Conte might consider the 3-5-2.
No, absolutely spot on. Like you said, I think Son's injury is a massive thought into this decision, plus the extra man. So look, can't say anything you haven't added. Let's get straight into it, Jacko. So look, in goals, we've gone with Hugo Lloris. He practically picks himself. I mean, he's available. He plays, especially with the sort of the magnitude of the game. You're never going to see Gallini in this. Davinson Sanchez also picks himself, along with Ben Davies at left side of centre back. He also picks himself. But Jack, Joe Roden has come in. Can you explain why?
I think Joe Roden has come in, obviously, because Eric Dier, of course, is still out with injury. I believe he also potentially had COVID at one stage. So a combination of an injury and COVID has definitely ruled him out for this one. But also Tanganga, someone who we have definitely rated, you know, very highly on this channel, is in some pretty poor form at this moment in time, where he had that huge two huge mistakes against Chelsea. And then another big mistake as well against Morecambe. So just feels like, you know, Tanganga, he just needs to be kind of ruled out for this one, just in poor form. So Joe Rodon, who did start in the middle of a back three against Morecambe, I guess this will be his time to shine. And so he's going to be in the middle of the back three, Dave.
Yeah, and just quickly to add to that, look, with Tanganga, he's very naive. We've seen the mistakes he made, especially the one in the FA Cup final. I mean, it's just one of the oldest tricks in the book. You wait for the defender to look where the ball is, and then you make your move where he can't see you where you're making it. You go and get bet in the air. With Tanganga, I mean, for me, take him out of the fire line. And the reason why I think we should go with Roden today is purely because he has had that experience playing championship football down in the championship. Yeah. So he does know the sort of them small tricks of the trade. And maybe we might see a better performance. But also, it just didn't look right with Davies, Sanchez in the middle, and Tanganga outright. So maybe with bringing Roden in, it might bring a bit more balance to the defence.
That's another good point, actually. Sanchez just didn't do well in the middle of the back three, like, at all. And so if Tanganga were to come in, that would mean Sanchez would have to go back into the middle of the back three, which just simply didn't work last time out. But we've gone for the wingbacks of Emerson and Reguilón. I feel like they just picked themselves. We all know, Matt Doherty, just to a degree, just doesn't compete with Emerson for the right wingback spot. And as well as Sessegnon, who did, you know, feature against Morecambe. Maybe that's a consideration that then Reguilón is being saved, I feel like, probably for this match against Chelsea. But we've gone through three men in the midfield, and we've gone for Højbjerg, Winks, and Skip. I feel like, you know, a lot of people have called for Højbjerg to be dropped for this one. I could totally understand why, but it does feel like he is someone that is still trusted by Antonio Conte, regardless of form. But we have gone for Harry Winks, Dave, instead of maybe Tanguy or Gio. Maybe what's the logic behind that?
Yeah, just quickly, I do want to add to Højbjerg quickly is, look, this is going to be a fight. The reason why we have continued at Højbjerg is because he will fight. If you're looking for a dogfight, if you're looking to turn this into a dogfight, he is your man. You can't rely on Lo Celso, Ali, or Ndombele to do that. So that's why Højbjerg is in. When it comes to Harry Winks, look, I actually think he's deserved it, Jack, to be honest with you. Look, he scored that goal against Morecambe. He has had some very good appearances of late under Antonio Conte. So why not bring him in? Because what we did miss against Chelsea was someone that maybe did have that passing in the to find Harry Kane or find the run of a Lucas or a Son. So this time, hopefully, Harry Winks will be able to do that. He'll be able to get the ball to Kane, be able to get the ball to Lucas in good positions and maybe find them in behind. Because the last couple of games, what we have seen is everything's been played in front of them. Against Chelsea, everything was played in front of them. Against Morecambe, everything was played in front of them. We need to ask questions going the other way. And we're bringing Harry Winks in with some of the passing ability that he has shown over the last few weeks, being able to pass forward. This guy can bring it, and then we can start asking questions of that retirement village of Chelsea's at the back.
Great point, Dave. To be fair to Winks as well, I must say, you know, he did actually answer the call when Liverpool came, you know, and he also had to deal with a lot of pressure, a lot of, you know, high pressing. Mm-hmm. He actually had a fantastic game in that sort of scenario. So love to see Harry Winks do more of the same. If he has a great game against Chelsea, I will say I will actually be convinced actually that Antonio Conte has repaired what we thought at one stage was, you know, a broken career with Harry Winks. But we've gone for Lucas and Harry Kane, of course, with the absence of Sonny because of injury, because of, I believe, a muscular sort of injury of some kind. He will be out for this one. Some shouts for maybe Steven Bergvijn, you know, coming into this one. I think he's also dealing miraculously with another injury. He's had so many injuries over his span here at Spurs, and he might potentially be available for this one, but I think we all know you probably would rather have a combination of Lucas Moura as well as, you know, Harry Kane for this one, Dave. So we've gone for Lucas Moura and Harry Kane. I mean, any thoughts on that? I mean, I think it just makes sense. It picks itself, but maybe any thoughts?
Look, when we done a debate last night, the transfer update, I encourage everybody to go back and check. If you haven't watched it, do go and watch it. Absolutely incredible. Mr. Spurs brought up a point about Bergvijn. Yeah, I think he said it was he's missed. He's been unavailable for 16 out of our 26 games so far this season. He's just pure injury prone. But as well, we're still not sure whether he's actually going to be back in time for tonight's game. It's still touch and go. So that's why we have gone with Lucas and Kane and left him out and changed the formation also because of Sonny's injury. But look, even if he was fit, I would still feel more comfortable going with Kane and Lucas because you don't know what you're going to get out of Bergvijn. He could play well and grab a goal and assist like he did against West Ham in the quarterfinal, or else he could be non-existent and you can't afford to take that risk. With Harry Winks, one thing you do know is he will at least try and put it in. Even if he's bad, he will still try and do something. And I think on that basis, with the starting 11, Jack, we've picked, obviously outside of injuries, we've picked the best 11 that we feel can go against this game in a dogfight. And I think it's logical as well. Now, look, we could be completely wrong, but I do think this is a potential. You could see this tonight, this lineup.
Yeah, I think Conte is just going to, as much as he seems to prefer the 3-4-3, I think he is going to go for a 3-5-2. And that would be hopefully something that we get right. If we don't get it right, then, you know, I would say, fair play to him. And hopefully, you know, he gets the right lineup. But he certainly doesn't have the best options available to him. And he does need transfers to come in January. But that is our predicted lineup, everybody. Again, we'll run through it one more time here. Lloris in goal. Sanchez, right center back. Roden, middle of the back three. Davies, a left-sided center back. Reguilón as our wing back, as well as Emerson. Højbjerg, Winks, and Skippy is going to be our midfield, with Winks probably sitting in the middle of that three, with Højbjerg and Skippy doing the hard work on the wings there. And then Lucas and Harry Kane up top. Hopefully this is the right sort of formula. Hopefully this is the right sort of lineup to get that result against Chelsea, because we do need that early goal. But that is the end of the predicted lineup, everybody. Hopefully you do enjoy it. Hopefully you guys can now, you know, at least take a look at the predicted lineup before you see the pre-match buildup that we will be doing tomorrow. And you will have, you know, a bit of a basis for what we're thinking about could be the winning formula in order to get back into this tie against Chelsea.
No, look, 100%. It's just the start of what's to come on this channel today, like Jack alluded to. You know, we have the pre-match build-up. Then we also have the watch-along, and we always stay on after the watch-along for a good, heavy debate on what we have seen. So plenty of content coming up today. This is just the build-up for what is going to be a massive day today. Carabao Cup semi-final, second leg. Let's get after it. We're Tottenham Hotspur. Maybe we can do this today. Everything's against us. But look, on our day, Tottenham Hotspur can turn up in semi-finals. We've seen that before. Arsenal 5-1. We've done them before in a semi-final. The opportunity is there. Let's go and attack it. Make sure you smash that like button. Smash that subscribe button. Get your comments in underneath. And we'll see you all back here later on.
Come on, you Spurs.